Okay, so this is test number 10. Electrical property of a real component can be drastically different in the direct and alternating currents. For example, the real resistance of a capacitor is what? Is the real resistance of a capacitor is looking at the next sentence. Since in the middle of the plate is and in the middle of the plate of the capacitor is what? In the middle of the capacitor is and what is in the middle of a capacitor? Is an insulator. Okay. So, what is the resistor? What is the resistance of an insulator? What is the resistance of an insulator? What is the resistance of an insulator? Ideally, it is infinity. The resistance of the insulator, but we can also say that the resistance of the insulator is large. Okay, it's large because it is an insulator. What is the meaning of the insulator? What is the meaning of the insulator? Where the direct current pass. What does it mean where the direct current pass? Where the direct current cannot, okay, cannot pass the insulator. So that's why we say that the real resistance of a capacitor. If you ask about the real resistance of the capacitor, it means that you ask about the resistance for the DC current that can the current pass the capacitor. But however, the alternating current now, what should you put? Here, the alternating current pass the capacitor, can pass the capacitor. Okay, can pass the capacitor since the charge on the plate is what in time? In fact, we may ignore this is. We may say that since the charge on the plate change, in time. Okay, change in time. From the definition of the current, I is equal to what? The definition of the current. What is the definition of the current? I is equal to dQ by dt. And since the charge change, we may say that the current on the capacitor is effectively not zero. You can see that I use the word effectively here mean we don't have the real current passed through the capacitor, but from the change of the chart on the plate, it seems like that we can pass the current through the capacitor, but it's not the real current, but it is the change of the this change of the chart that produce something that like current pass the capacitor. So that's why I use the word effectively. It's not a real current, but in the language of the Maxwell equation, it is a displacement current. If you look at the electromagnetic field that I assigned last time for you to read the electromagnetic chapter, you will see the word displacement current. Okay. In the same manner, so next, now for the inductor. The ideal inductor, when we say that the ideal inductor is mean that the inductor is made from the ideal metal or ideal conductor. And the ideal conductor mean that the resistance of the conductor is zero. The resistance of the conductor is zero. So, if the resistance of the conductor is zero, the ideal conductor has what resistance? The ideal conductor has zero resistance. When a direct current passes through the inductor, the potential difference is, and since the inductor has a real zero resistance, if we pass the direct current, what is the potential difference? We have V equal to I R, and if R is zero, what is the value of V? Zero, yes, because it means that the potential difference is zero for the ideal conductor. Now, if we change the source to be AC source in an AC circuit, the current again, the current what in time change, okay? So the key of the AC source is that it produces the potential difference and also the current that change in time. And because of this change, the potential difference across the inductor change in time. The current that pass the inductor change in time. And when the current change in time, it induce the electromotive force, and the potential across the inductor is now equal to the L di by dt. Okay, so that is the formula for the potential difference across the inductor. Okay, so that is for the question number one. Next. Consider the phase diagram of three RLC circuits. If the capacitance have the same value, what the order of XL? Okay, you have three. You have three phase diagram. The first one is this is I, and this is V. Okay, this is for the choice A. hand for B. We have I and V. I and V have the same direction. Okay, this is for B and this is for C. And when they ask which, what is the order of XL, A, B, for the three situation, it means that you need to know which one